Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we're on the Olympic Peninsula of Washington, fishing for coho salmon in the Straits of Juan, Fuca, using trolling flies. Now, if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Today, we're on the far reaches of the Olympic Peninsula out of CQ, Washington, fishing the narrow strip of water between the Olympic Peninsula and Vancouver Island.
Good morning. We're in CQ, Washington, and we are going to head out to the Juan de Fuca Straits and go for some silver salmons this morning here.
First thing we're going to do this morning is some bucktailing. We're going to run the smaller motor once we get out there because it puts out a lot bigger bubble stream. And then I'm going to be running a big trolling fly with an action disc. It's going to be in or right next to the bubble stream or right beyond it at the back end. The fish want to come up and they get curious about it, but if you're running a fly back there, it can be a real high percentage thing, especially early in the morning. We did well yesterday with it.
So right here we are looking at the fishing grounds here that we've been fishing for the last few days. So we launched out of here at CQ. This is the Juan de Fuca Straits here. And these are all the target areas that we've been catching fish in the last few days.
What we're doing is running a trolling fly that's a tube fly. And the tube fly slides onto the line, and then you have your choice of what you want for hooks in the back. What I've got here are beads in order to space the hook back to the tail end of the fly. And I use glow-in-the-dark beads. Maybe it helps, you know, but especially in the evening. But it's sliding on the line. The advantage is that you can pick the type of hook that you want to use. And my preference is a relatively short shank hook that is harder for the fish to throw. The longer the shank gets, the more leverage they can get against you, and they have a better chance of getting over it. But what we're doing today are barbless hooks. And then up here, I've got a wiggle fin action disc. And it's gonna put a little bit of wiggling action to the fly.
Still a little dark, so we're gonna troll out to the fishing grounds. By the time we get our lines rigged up and set, we should be right in the mix of where we've been catching the fish. So we're setting back 25 to 30 feet. And for this downrigger, we're gonna go down 30 feet.
But each of these is a tube fly that slides on up and down on the line, but the water pressure pushes it back. And then I've got an action disc ahead of them that you'll be able to see a little later on how they swim in the water when they're going through. With a lot smaller tube flies, I do that for fresh water where there's small bait fish in the water. But some of what was happening here yesterday were smaller bait fish. So instead of the giant flies, we're gonna try some small ones as well.
Fish on, Tony.
He got off. Yeah.
Bring him up and we'll spray him with some scent. Make sure I spray my, don't spray myself here.
Yesterday we had 60 fish that we caught, and out of the 60 fish, only 8 of them were hatchery fish, and you only could keep the hatchery fish, but it took us 60 fishes to get 8 good sized keepers yesterday. This is one of Dennis Pierce black and white tube flies and stuff. So we're gonna tip this with a small piece of herring here and see if we could get a fish to take the bite. So we just tip, just run it through like that, you know, just hang like that. We'll give it a shot. And set back 25 feet, 25 to 30 feet.
What I'm doing is I've got a piece I've got leaded line with a short leader at the end, and I'm running it in back and forth and up and down and around the end of the bubbles coming out of the back of the this little motor here, and it's called bucktailing is the technique. But the silvers are attracted to the bubbles, and they'll come up from a long ways down and come up and take a fly in and around these bubbles. And what I like to do is run it through it and come out one side and then take it back. But something to just try to entice a strike out of them. But it's sort of a visual thing. And when they hit it, it's real electric. And it's just your basic fly setup. But I've got lead core to a short leader system so that it will stay below the surface. Skimming on the surface is okay, but I kind of like it an inch or two down and swimming back and forth.
Welcome back to the Strait of Juan de Fuca. I'm Justin Wolf. We're targeting coho with trolling flies on the far northern coast of Washington, and so far, so good.
We'll see if I can get them in.
Is he pulling hard yet?
Yeah, he's pulling pretty hard. We'll see what he looks like when we get him close.
The real good ones, Jason caught one that was like seven plus pounds just the other day, but you have to weed through a whole bunch of little guys, but this doesn't appear to be a little guy.
We have to go over behind. So there's no out of his fin there. So this is a hatchery fish. So we could keep it. This is a keeper fish.
He's gone.
Yeah, but we're
oh. Maybe.
Does he have one?
Action.
Take? He's pulling pretty good.
I thought that line go off.
This is my first year of ever salmon fishing, and it's been so exciting. Feel him pull and fight. Really enjoying retirement. It looks like he's over here. Here he's coming.
Bring him over here. Bring him
over here. Over here? Okay.
Just let him go where he wants to go.
Okay. Here he comes.
Woo-hoo! Easy, Tony. Good job. Easy. Hold on, Tony, it's too tight.
Jesus. This is the water-soluble krill, and with a hint of sardine flavor to it. But we're gonna put it into the fly and get it to work down through it. And I think if we do it at the nose, it'll work down through the body of it over time.
All right, we just refreshed this bait here. We put a new piece of herring and some spray on there, and we got a bite within 5 minutes, so. Just a small little shaker. Here we go. That's a hatchery fish there, no fin.
This fly isn't glow in the dark, but the beads underneath it are, and if you use a UV light, but we're not getting much sunlight today, and I think we need the UV in order to get the beads to really glow in the water. But you can see there's a number of the materials in the fly are glow or UV reflective, but it's the beads that are the glow in the dark that hold the charge better. But this is the wiggle fin slide lock bead, and the way it works is you squeeze it across the split in it, and you got to get it exactly horizontal or else it doesn't open up. But the neat thing about them is that it gives you a good quarter inch or more of friction on the line. you know, as a bobber. It's a bobber stop is what it is. And I use that to set the action disc the distance I want above the fly, like that. And by changing the distance that the disc is above the fly, it changes the way the fly swims. So depending on how fast you want to go, put it in the water, look at it, and you'll see, you know, if you want more action, less action to the fly. But the closer the disc is to the nose of the fly, the more action it's got. The bigger discs do more of a kicking action like a dodger. The smaller disc do more of a vibration to make it, you know, vibrate like it's like a fish swimming. Because he's at 50 back, I'm only going to go back about 40, trying to keep them away from each other, maybe even high 39 or 40. And then he's down at 35, so I'm only going to take it to 25. You can see by the tip of the rod how much action the wiggle disc is putting. That's the number two, the larger wiggle disc, and what it's doing, you know, the tip of the rod will show you what's happening back at the fly.
Today is 9/11 today. We gotta remember for all the people that lost their lives during 9/11 and all the people that helped save the people for the rescue and the people that went to war for us.
It's September 11th, and with the colors flying, Jason Lai is putting us on some fish in the Strait of Juan de Fuca, where the whales are likely feeding on the same bait that we're imitating with our Arctic fox trolling flies. According to the Fishhawk TD, it's 54.5 degrees at the surface and about 5 degrees cooler 50 feet down and deeper.
Okay. Most of the change was in the top 40 feet, and then once it got to 50, it's pretty much staying there all the way down to 100 feet in depth. So we've only been catching fish at mostly 25, 35. I think we caught, we might have been fishing at 50 at some of the time, but the fish have been up near the, you know, the 25 to 35 foot range, and maybe these temperatures tell the story.
Feels like a light one.
You got one, Tyron?
Here.
Got a good one, yeah. No. You got one too, Tony?
Yeah,
okay, we got into him. Okay, I'll get the net. Where's the net on this side?
No, mine's off.
Yours off, yours on, Tony?
Yeah. Come on, baby.
Or mine's the baby. Tony's got one right here, yeah.
He's swimming towards me or something, because he's...
Okay. Hey! You bet.
There's a bunch of beads here on this body here, so what we'll do is we'll cut the line here and we'll add some more beads to it to push this hook. So it pushes the hook here so it lays down on the end like this. So we want that hook kind of on that tail end of that feather there instead of up here in the body, because the fishes are biting right over here.
Okay, how many beads do you want?
Well, I think we're gonna need probably three or four beads.
Four, okay.
Yeah.
He's a little one.
Yeah.
But it's something. See? Putting those beads on? Paid off.
You're a genius.
Oh,
why? You should be a consultant.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, if I get paid, I will consult.
Bigger fish. We need bigger fish now. We're starting to get the hookups. So hopefully we'll get into the bigger fish. You got that, Richard?
Yeah, bigger fish.
Bigger fish. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
It's taking line out.
I'm excited. Yeah, about time we got one.
Yeah. And bring it over me. Under me.
Got
him.
Whoa,
good. Hey!
This is one of the new model glow-in-the-dark squids, and it was slow. We went through a dry spell of an hour, hour and a half, and then we stopped the boat, dinked with motor a little bit, started it up, and then the fish hit. And I think that there might be a lesson in that, as far as, you know, letting everything sink, starting the boat back up and getting everything to come back up where it came, is a change from just being a straight ahead trolling thing. And then I'm finding that turns and elevation changes that you get from stopping the boat, letting things sink, and then fire the boat back up even faster than it was going before to get stuff to rise up and then come back. But change is real important, I think, you know, on provoking a strike rather than just a continuous straight ahead, you know, trolling technique. So anyways, that's what I got out of it.
I got, thank you, Lord, for having me hit my line. It worked.
We're going back to the Strait of Juan de Fuca, but first, here's your Fish Field Tackle Connection. Fishing for salmon with trolling flies is effective and a whole lot of fun. You might want to give it a try, but you want to make sure that you've got the right type of rod, a trolling rod that's not too heavy. Now, what you do is go to fishfield.com and check out their big selection of rods, in particular the G. Loomis rods. They've got some great trolling rods there in the medium category that'll be just right for trolling flies. Now, you've got a choice between a cork handle and a carbon fiber handle. Carbon fiber handles have been very, very popular for the last few years, but I'm starting to see cork handles kind of come back into style. Cork is lighter, easier on the hands, it's warmer in the winter. The main disadvantage is you can't pull the cork out of a rod holder as easily as you can a carbon fiber. Carbon fiber cleans up easier, and of course it's more durable. Either way, you're gonna put some fish in the boat. Now, let's go back to the Strait of Juan de Fuca and see if we can't hook up with a few more coho.
Welcome back to the Strait of Juan de Fuca, or as they say in Canada, the Juan de Fuca Strait. We've got a good number of hookups so far, but we're noticing that a certain color pattern is the most productive on this day.
The best fly so far today has been with Richard, with this one of these flies, which is a UV glow-in-the-dark squid pattern, basically in white, but we are putting glow beads on them to try to get more glow and more light out of them at a little bit of depth. But we're going to put another one on and see if it's the fly or if it's Richard that's got the hot stick for some other reason. Anyways, that's what we're going to put on. What we've been using is 12 pound standard monofilament rather than fluorocarbon, anything like that. This particular one, this has been the fly that's been the most successful on that rod right over there. And what I've done is added glow in the dark beads to move the hook all the way to the rear of the materials as it's swimming through the water. The rest of it, it's about glow in the dark and putting it in the sun for a while, or else hitting it with a UV light is what it takes. But the idea behind this was at depth or in low light conditions early in the morning to have something that really lights up. But it's got a lot of sparkle to it, and it'll glisten, you know, up in the where the sun penetrates down through the water as well. The other thing I did was I added a larger wiggle fin action disc. This one acts more like a dodger, and it makes the fly kick rather than wiggle. And that's the difference between, you know, the number two and the number one disc. And yeah, running it this far up will make the fly sort of jump back and forth side to side. Just saw a couple of fish rolling or jumping on the surface, so I'm gonna try running a couple of flies right up on top. I think what I'm gonna try is add a snap weight to get it just a couple inches below the surface so it's not skipping on the top at this speed, and see if what happens. I think we're gonna put the snap weight on about 25 feet ahead of the flies, and then run it out back. And that's what it does. As you reel back in, you can just pop it right back off and get it out of your way so you can reel in the line, ultimately. Not a lot of weight on it, but enough to get it maybe a foot below the surface or so. Fish on.
It's been dead for a while, and in the last half hour, we got three good bites and stuff in this afternoon here, so maybe the tide changed or picked up or something. Put that All right. Ready, Tony?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Nice. I hope he don't have them.
All right. If he starts coming to my side.
Your side, huh?
My line is quite.
Oh, I see him. I see him back there. Yeah. He took that line out of ways. Huh?
He's still out there a ways.
You see him? Or is that you? Maybe he's right here.
Okay.
Oh, he looks pretty.
Whoa, that's a nice fat one.
He looks pretty. Okay, Tony, he's right in here.
Where's he at?
Can you see him?
No. Okay, he's over here. I see him. There he is. Bring him in.
Come and bring him in. Slowly, maybe. Okay, let's get him now. Get him now.
Got him!
Hello, good one, Tony. Good one.
Hey, looks nice, huh?
You got a fin?
No,
not. I don't see a fin. Do you guys? No fin.
No fin.
No fin! Yay!
There you go, Rich.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching today's episode. And be sure to stop by the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. I'm sure we can help you catch more fish. And remember, without the sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.